everyone. Eggnog Warrior here, and today we're going to play some Rimworld. I just got this game not too long ago. I have played it through a couple of times, but on the easiest difficulty setting. Today we're going to play it on a little more difficult setting and see how it goes. I'm from the reviews that I've read, this game can get pretty brutal. What we're going to do is we're going to use the crash-landed scenario, which starts with three survivors and some resources here. I'm going to go next. Now we get to our storyteller selection. The storyteller decides how difficult or easy the game is going to be. If you're just in it for the base building, which is actually a lot of fun all by itself, you would choose Phoebe Chillax and Peaceful, which makes the game pretty, you know, peaceful. We're going to choose the classic AI storyteller and go rough and see how difficult that is. This is generating our world. You see it's going to generate about 30% of the world using this random seed that it picked for us. I'm going to generate the world. This should only take, I don't know, 10, 15 seconds or so for it to render the world. What it's going to do is pre-populate with a bunch of settlements. You can see here, the skulls and crossbones are raider or pirate settlements, and the other ones are not friendly necessarily, but kind of traders. Anyway, so you can see the game, if you hold down the middle mouse button to move around, you can scroll around and see what's going on. You can see it's rendered about 30% of the world for us. But it turns out that that's plenty, because if we zoom way in using the mouse wheel, of course, you can see it's divided into these little hexes, like an old school board game. It's divided into hexes, and there are a lot of hexes available here. So we're going to select a random site. Sea ice. Do we really want to grow and try to have a settlement on sea ice? I don't think we do. It's not showing me the stats over there. No, that's not what I want. Whatever. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that's where we're going to be. That's going to be our site. Arid Shrubland. I'm going to go next. These are our three colonists. We've got Kevin Greer, Olga Kunicki, and Kate Huang. And we're going to start. So now it's generating the map for our little hex that we picked at random. You see the crash-landed ship there on the world. The three of you awake in your crypto-sleep sarcophagi to the sound of sirens and ripping metal. You barely get to the escape pods before the ship is torn apart. Sometime later, you land on this unknown rim world. As pieces of the shredded starship fall around you, you start making plans to survive. All right. There's our three pods landing. Person. I'm going to press the space bar to pause the game. And what we're going to do is select everything. And you can see the red X's mean that all this stuff is forbidden. They can't, our colonists can't touch it or gather it. So we're going to press F to unforbid it. We're going to do that for everything. For each of these weapons, there's the knife, the pistol, the rifle, all this wood. Let's see how much wood there is here. Double clicking a thing will select all of it on the map. Do that, and then there's some steel over here. We're going to select all the steel we can find, unforbid that. So we do not have much in the way of wood. You can see we've got, there's more steel. Cool. We can see we've got some trees that we could cut down for wood. We could hollow our way into this mountain. Maybe let's try to do that. Where are my colonists? Oh, there they are. Okay. Oh, there's more food over here. Cool. Unselect that. So we're going to... what I want to do... so we need beds. It says over here on the right, and a hunter lacks her long-range weapon. So if that's our hunter, we're going to give her the rifle. I want to see Olga. What can she do? She has no shooting skill at all. Greer has one shooting skill. So we're going to give Greer the pistol. And we're going to give Olga... the knife. Just right-clicking on the item and then telling her to equip it. We're going to unforbid the medicine. How much wood do we have? We have a fair amount of wood. Not a lot. What's interesting is these cacti can actually be cut down for wood as well. Let's deconstruct that. That'll give us some steel. Let's see here. Alright. I guess let's just go into this mountain. These here are compacted steel, so we can dig some more steel out of the mountain. This brown stuff is compacted machinery, which gives us more of, where are my colonists? I keep losing them. These components here. See, we have 30 of them. Mining the compacted machinery will give us more of those, which are handy later in the game. You know what we're going to do? Is we're going to build this out. Put a few beds in it. Furniture, bed. Rotate it around using the E key. Whoops, that's not where I wanted to put that. Cancel that. Build a copy of that. There. They're going to put three beds there. Let's see. Early in the game, it's best probably to have them share a bedroom. We're going to unpause the game and press 3. There we go. They're grabbing some wood and they're going to come do this. Tent structure. We're going to build a wall here. A door here. So they're building their... I'm going to press L so they come up and mine that. So I want them to build a wall here and a door here. That'll make this an indoor area so they can have a nice place to sleep. There we go. See, he's building a roof on it. That's good. Okay, so now they've got a place to sleep. Let's see. Now we need to find a food source. There's a lot of compacted machinery here. That's excellent. Components are in short supply later in the game. Let's see. I'm going to click on work down here and see who is allowed to mine. Only Greer and Olga can mine, so we're just going to make them both mine. We're going to have two people be able to grow. While the game is paused, I'm going to click Architect, Zone Area, and define some growing zones. I usually go about 7x7. Because that seems to be enough to feed your colony for a while. Can't grow on desert. That doesn't surprise me. It makes perfect sense. You know what? It's fine. We're just going to do this. Grow what we can. So this one is going to grow potato plants. This one I want to grow corn. And this one I want to grow rice. Finally, we're going to do a new growing zone. Another 7x7 area. I don't know, I just picked 7x7 kind of arbitrarily. And we're gonna go grow cotton here. So then Olga is clearing the way. She's cutting down some cactuses and trees. Gonna get the areas ready to grow. We've got our beds. You can see they're unowned right now. Once the colonists have decided to come and sleep in them, what will they do? They'll claim the bed, and it will have their name on it. Later on, we'll try to build rooms for each of them, bedrooms. So they're all very busy with that right now, with growing. How much wood do I have left? If I double-click, I can see I have 162 wood, which is not a lot. I'll get some bricks so we can do some more building. I'm just holding down Shift and selecting each of these. I'm going to click Deconstruct. Hopefully someone will go up there and deconstruct that. So Olga is planting. She's planting cotton, which is not exactly what I want just yet, but that's fine. So Greer is up here deconstructing this area. That'll give us some blocks to build with. I want to build two more zones. I just paused the game. We're going to do a stockpile zone. We're going to make that 10x10, and I also need a dumping zone. Make that 10x10 also. All right. The dumping zone is where they will put things like these rocks here. If they need to move them, if I tell them to haul those, they'll put them here. And then the stockpile zone really should have a roof on it because a lot of items will deteriorate if they're in an unroofed area. But we don't have enough materials just yet to build that out, so that's fine. Maybe if I built a small room. Let's see. I'm not going to need heaters because it's pretty warm here. You can see in the right-hand corner here, it's 53 degrees out, which is not... It's not hot, obviously, but it's not super cold either, so they'll be comfortable enough. They'll eventually put this steel here in this dumping zone. stockpile zone, rather. So she should just put the medicine there. And some wood, some steel. Good, good, good. They're moving all this stuff to where it should go. I should have... Oh, a minor break risk. Oh, I want to talk about that a little bit. If I look at my... Who is going to break? Kate. If I look at Kate and I click on character... Nope. If I click on needs, I can see the green improves her mood, the red decreases or harms her mood. Since she ate without a table, she's not feeling very well, she slept in the cold, she shares a bedroom, she's joy deprived. That we can fix. If I go to architect, click joy, I can make a horseshoe pin out of wood. We'll just put it right there. And he'll build that. That'll be super quick, so they can come play horseshoes when they want to. I don't know where they got the horseshoes, but they can play horseshoes now if they want to. Is this all deconstructed? Yes. So we're going to click floors, remove floor, and remove the floor from underneath that wall. That will give me a few more blocks to work with. What I want to do is try to build a room here over this so that that stuff won't deteriorate from being outside. So I'm going to go to structure, I'm going to go to wall, limestone blocks. There. I'm going to define the whole wall, but they won't be able to build it because they just don't have enough blocks, and that's fine. I wonder if there is another limestone wall around. Ooh, elephants. Neat. I've never seen elephants before. What is this? Yeah, that's limestone. Let's deconstruct this so we have more blocks to work with. It's a little tedious. I should be able to double-click. I just think that should work that way. But it doesn't, so you have to single-click all of them. They're all getting some sleep now. We've got 69 blocks left, which is just not going to get us very far. I'm going to cancel that and build out of limestone a door right there. See, it takes longer to build with... stone than it does with wood. Oh, construction failed, so we wasted some materials there, but that's fine. Oh, you know what I want to do, actually? Let's cancel all of that, because that's unnecessary. Okay, he's building. This is going pretty well. None of that's been deconstructed yet. Is this limestone? Yeah, it is. Sweet. So Greer is busy building. When he's done building, he'll go up and deconstruct that wall. What is this? That is a dead squirrel. Let's look at the storage options here. I don't want to store human-like corpses, but I will store animal corpses because I can butcher them later. He's doing pretty well building this room out, but... And Kate is busy hauling all of our stuff here. We have a visitor that has a few items to trade. Let's see if we look at the character sheets. Who is our most social? Greer has a 5 for social. Nothing. Nothing. All right. So let's have Greer talk to our visitor. Where is our visitor? Jump to location. There it is. Greer, trade with Cave. His name is Cave, apparently. What has he got? Nutrient paste meals, packaged survival. Oh, no, that's us. We have packaged survival meals to sell, but we're not going to sell. So we have 800 silver to spend here. The trader has 241 silver that he can use to buy stuff from us. I'm going to buy this jacket. Oh, yeah, I'm going to buy this jacket so that somebody can... No, you know, I'm not. I'm going to not do any trading with him. That's fine. Looks like he started deconstructing up here. Greer has. Oh, my goodness. It's so tedious to get your initial colony set up. I'm going to cancel that, and I'm going to build... a wood door here. That little traitor guy is just going to wander around our camp for a while. And then now he's gone. Now he's leaving. Okay, cool. Our little growing plots are underway. Our corn plot. Oh, Greer thinks you should give your faction a name. We're going to call it Crosbyton. Okay, that's fine. Since it looks like you'll be here for a while, Greer also thinks that you should give your community a name. And this community is going to be called Meborn. That's fine. That's fine. I usually just accept whatever they want to call themselves. I don't have anything invested in naming them in a particular way. Alright. So they're going to eat. He's going to build a door, and he's going to go back up and deconstruct some stuff here. That's fine. I wonder... Oh, wait. So let's do this. Let's... Architect. Oh, look, more ship chunks. More, holy moly, look at all those. I want to deconstruct all of those. That'll give us more steel and more components. Kate is about to break again. I don't know what her deal is. So we don't have a meal source currently. I'm going to make a butcher table. It has a work speed penalty from being outdoors, and that's fine. So the way you use these tables is you have to define a bill. I'm going to tell you a bill. I'm going to butcher a creature. Uh-oh. We have a mad animal. So I need Kate, who has the gun, to come shoot at it. He has a gun also. So I want to tell Kate to stand here, and tell Greer to stand here, and they're going to shoot at this deer. Or... gazelle, I guess it is. Come on, kill it. Kill it, kill it. Why are you... Okay, good. So what we could do is, once it's dead, once it eventually dies... Okay. Now I'm going to undraft them and let them go about their business. So, as I was saying, with the butcher table, what you do is you define a bill, and you say... butcher however many creatures, and what I usually do is just set it to some very high number. Not very high, but set it to some high number. That way, as creatures become available, they will just go ahead and butcher them. Alright, good. Good. So we've got some meat here that is deteriorating due to being unroofed and will spoil in a day. So the other building, or the other thing I need to make, is what? A fueled stove. I'm building them outside right now. I shouldn't, but I am. I'm going to build it outside and then eventually, hopefully, enclose it in a wall. But it's going to be a while before I have the materials to do that. If I check their needs, you can see they're all unhappy because they're sharing a bedroom, which I think is a little whiny for people who just crash-landed on a planet. But what can you do? There's no way to fast forward the nighttime where they're sleeping. Some colonists will be night owls, and when a colonist is a night owl, you can redefine their hours using this assign button, not the assign button, this restrict button, and have them sleep during the day and work during the night, and that makes them a little happier. Night owls awake in the daytime suffer a mood penalty. It seems like virtually everything you can do makes them suffer a mood penalty. So now I'm going to add a bill to my stove that I just built to cook a simple meal. And I'm going to do this, do until you have X instead, and leave it at 10. That way, who can cook? Whoops. I don't know what my computer just did. Who can cook? Greer can cook. Olga can cook, but has a zero skill. We're going to have her cook anyway. Alright, cool. So he's making some meals. That's good. They'd spoil much less quickly. You can see that it's going to spoil in 3 days, whereas the food that just sits out is going to spoil in... Well, the meat anyway is going to spoil in a day. The agave fruit spoils in a season in 6 days, which is great. Except for, again, it's deteriorating due to being unroofed. As soon as this building is done... Oh, someone has joined us. Marl has joined us. Marl is naked. You can see she has no gear whatsoever. Eventually, I'm going to need to build a thing so I can make clothes. What's Marl doing? Oh, she's deconstructing this. Okay, that's good. That's going to give us more blocks to work with. So you can see sometimes just people just randomly join. And I haven't been raided yet, which I think is interesting. I played another game earlier, the other day, on a harder difficulty level, and we got raided all the time. But that hasn't happened here yet. So, I'm building walls, getting some more sleep. Oh no, I don't have a bed for Marl, so she's just going to sleep on the ground. Poor Marl. I wonder if I can put a bed right next to another bed. Furniture, bed. Put it. No, not there. Cancel that. Build a copy. Oh, is Marl a night owl? Let's check it out. No, she's pretty and she's lazy. All right, that's great. Thanks, game. He is jealous and a green thumb. Careful shooter, too smart, and a chemical interest. Chemical interest means they'll more likely to do drugs. Anyway, so someone has a relationship. Where's that at? Follow the arrow. Oh, so sometimes people will just wander through your colony, and it turns out that one of my colonists is related to one of them, and that's fine. They're just gonna move along and go on their way. Marl is really industrious. Okay, this wall is coming along. It's very, very slowly coming along. We have some wood. I wonder if I can build a wall, or I mean a room here. Structure. Build it out of wood. This is a dumb looking room, but I just need it to be enclosed. Oh, here we are getting raided. Let's close that. Jump to location. Okay, so I'm gonna take Greer and Kate and draft them. Oh, he's a ways off, that's fine. And I'm gonna tell them to go there. I want them to line up. Where's the bad guy? Female Drifter of the Thieves of Terrorism. Okay, that's quite a name. Alright, come on. Come on. Here, I'm gonna do this. Architect. What is it? Security. Sandbags. Work and see who has construct. I'm going to make everybody who can construct construct. So Olga's going to do that. This bad guy is just hanging out up here. That's not good. Alright. Okay, here comes Lady. Okay, so she's almost dead. I'm gonna undraft them. Olga is cowering. Okay. I'm gonna unforbid that. And this is beer. Alright, that raid wasn't so bad. Lady here is gonna die. If I look at her health, you can see she's bleeding to death. She's gonna be dead in 5 hours. Oh, she has an alcohol addiction. That's sad. That's very sad. But she's gonna die, and that's what she gets for raiding us. Alright, let's get some sleep. I'll wake up in the morning. Oh, you know what I need to do? So one of the things that's a problem is that I'm gonna go to miscellaneous, I'm gonna go to grave. Oh no, he just took a drink. Oh well, that's fine. If there are corpses laying around, your little dudes will suffer a mood penalty from seeing a corpse. So see, she's now that she's dead, they're gonna bury her. That way they don't see the corpse laying around. minor break risk again. Oh no, that went away. Okay, good. You can see unhappy nudity here. Marl is not happy about being naked. Okay, someone build this wall out. Just finish it. Don't have a lot of wood left. Okay, here we go. So now all that stuff that was deteriorating due to being unroofed is no longer going to do that. Good. And these production areas are not going to suffer their work penalty anymore. What I'm going to do, what I want to do is build a couple of solar power generators. Someone gonna do anything with that? Yeah, okay, there they go. I think this video is gonna be a long one. I was kind of hoping to do this until something interesting happened. And the raid was interesting, but I haven't suffered a catastrophic failure of a colony yet, which is, again, sort of what I was hoping would happen. Oh, he failed at constructing the solar panel. Which is unfortunate. There we go, and perfect. Now, what I want to do is... Oh, Greer got food poisoning. That's what that doo-doo just meant. I'm going to link them up with some wire. I need to build a battery. This isn't good. Are they going to be able to cross the battery if I put it here? I'm going to put two batteries there. And then I'm going to wire up a power conduit between them. There we go. That's perfect. What I want to do now is deconstruct that so we can put a door there. That's going to have to wait until morning. Hunter lacks ranged weapon. Good work. Who has hunt? Marl has hunt. An explorer named Nathaniel Hicklin calls you from nearby, being chased by pirates. So I'm going to offer him safety, and that means I'm going to have to fight the pirates. Let's go to architect. What did I want? Security. Sandbags. Whoops. Put some sandbags there. What they do is they use the sandbags for cover. Kate, here we are being raided. Press space to pause really quick. Group of pirates from Thieves of Terrorism are attacking immediately. Okay, so I need Greer and Kate here. Kate there. Greer here. Oh no. Oh no. So that's one dead. These are my only two people. Kate is on fire. That's bad. Oh no! Greer just died. So he's injured. Oh, he's got a like an incendiary launcher thing. Okay, so she killed him. We've got Nathaniel here trying to put out the fire. Okay, good. Good, good, good. And the last pirate's leaving, so Kate. Someone needs to come rescue Greer, though. Can rescue Greer. Okay, Olga's gonna rescue him. That'll put him in a bed to rest and heal up. And I'm missing a bed for what's his name who just joined. Furniture bed. Put that there. Oh, this green stuff here is vomit. Whoever got food poisoning is barfing all over the place. I'm gonna go to structure. Oh, I want a door out of limestone blocks here. Someone's got a major break risk. Oh man, some people are just not doing well. I guess that pirate attack was kind of rough on them. I want that gun, F. I want that club, F. I want this thing, F. F. So normally corpses are forbidden, but now they're going to pick them up and go bury them. That way they don't have to see a corpse lying around. This guy, I believe, is dying. Polo the Luddite. Uh-oh, someone has a severe illness. Greer has a severe illness. What has he got going on? Oh, he's gonna die. No one's treating him. Does anyone have the doctor? Oh, Greer is the only doctor. So I had to assign the doctor job to both Nathaniel. Nathaniel, are you awake? Yeah. Get some medicine. Uh-oh. Extreme break risk. Okay, so now Nathaniel is treating Greer, I believe. Nope, Greer just died. Well, shoot. Is that him dead here? Nope, that's Polo the Luddite, John the Butcher, Lady the Gardener. Oh, Nathaniel is sleeping in Greer's bed. That's gross. Because Greer is there. You can see his head behind Nathaniel. So Greer died. That's unfortunate. Greer is dead. He's not forbidden, so eventually someone will bury him. I hope. So our batteries are half charged. So I wanted batteries so that I could do an electric stove instead of a fueled stove, because that's going to use up my wood. Okay, so Greer just got buried, which is good, I guess. So deconstruct that stove, please, instead of using it, so I can build an electric stove. Uh-oh. Someone's got an infection. Marl's got a neck infection. An infection in her neck. And Marl has an infection in her right leg. So none of that is good. So if we look at the infection here, she's got... The infection is at 32%. Her immunity is at 28%. If the immunity outstrips the infection, she will eventually be fine. So her neck is infected. Uh-oh. Her right leg is infected. We might have to amputate. If I go here to operations, I can amputate legs, install peg legs. It's very silly. It's kind of a funny game. So now my stove is out of fuel. I need someone to come deconstruct it so that I can build my electric stove there. Oh good, cotton is being harvested, so I can build to make some clothes here soon, hopefully. And finish that door. And finish that door. My goodness, that's taking a long time. She just horked. Alright, so she finished the door. Building some sandbags that I can use for cover. Good. Perfect. So we have enough beds for everybody. Now we have an extra bed since Greer died. Good. That's getting deconstructed. I want to build an electric stove here. You can see, though, if I go to power... Oh, no, it's not built yet. That's fine. I don't know if you saw the little orange line. It was connecting itself to the solar panel, which is not what I want. I want it connected to the battery so I can use it all the time. But that can wait. So Marl is very, very sick. Extreme infection. Let's see. The infection's at 86. Her immunity's at 78. And this one, her infection's 67. Her immunity's 82. Looks like her right leg might be okay. But the neck, which cannot be amputated, I don't know what's going to happen there. We'll just have to see. So Nathaniel here is feeding Marl. Uh-oh, she just died. Well, that's sad. All right. Okay. Building that electric stove, that's good. Perfect. I'm trying to get it to connect to the batteries, but it doesn't seem to want to. Okay, you know what I'll do is at night the solar panels will lose power, and if I click reconnect at night when the solar panels aren't providing any power, it should connect to the battery, and that's fine. So let's add a bill to cook a simple meal until I have 10. Look at that, some potatoes have been harvested. This is great. Okay, good. Good, good, good. This is going pretty well so far. So, can Nathaniel use a ranged weapon? Yeah. That way Nathaniel and Kate will be our two people. Actually, Kate, I want you to use this incendiary launcher because I think that's ridiculous. And then Olga can't equip a weapon. Oh no, she can. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. So now all three people have ranged weapons. Minor break risk. Alright. If I look at work, I need everyone who can construct to construct. Everyone who can cut plants to cut plants. Solar flare has just begun, which means that none of my electronics will work. So, whatever. I will acknowledge that. What about this thing? I want to pull up the floors here, which will give me more blocks to work with again. And same here. Now everyone's going to go to sleep. Man, I just do not have enough materials to do anything useful. I barely got this wall built around our storage area. So what I want to do, let's build... Not furniture, not structure, production. Let's build an electric tailor bench. Because I think it's a little faster, and I'll put that there. Oh, I forgot to reconnect my stove to the batteries. Oh well, that's fine. So we're going to build an electric tailor bench, and then we can maybe make some clothes, even though the woman who was running around naked doesn't need them anymore. Okay. Wow, this is a pretty sad-looking little colony here. I want to make one other thing under production. I want to make... Not a sculptor's, a stonecutter's table. Put that there. Oh, I don't have the 75 wood I need for that. Alright, so let's see. Let's cut down some trees. That should give us plenty. Oak trees are worth quite a lot of wood. That one's at 96%. Okay. These cacti are ready to harvest. That oak tree is ready to harvest. Alright, cut down some trees. Do it up. Some trees and some cacti. Wow, 5 graves already filled. Alright. That cactus was only worth 10 wood. That's not useful to me at all. Okay, there's wood. Alright, cool. So now we should be able to build these things. Wow, I need 75 wood for each of them? Good grief. Someone needs to build that. Major break risk. Ooh, cargo pods. Stuff falls. Oh, wart. What am I going to do with that? Yeah, I'm going to leave that alone. I don't want that. That's for making beer, and I don't have the facilities to make beer, so I don't care. I'm not going to use that. An escape pod has fallen. Paisley. So if I go here and I rescue Paisley. Send Olga to do that. Wow, that's a long ways out, isn't it? Okay, so what she'll do is she'll bring him back and put him in a bed. And once he's all healed up from his crash, he may stay and join the colony, or he might just wander off, which they do sometimes. Where are you, Olga? There you are. Alright, cool. Can't believe that infection killed what's-her-name. That's pretty sad. What? Paisley has died because of blood loss. Alright, because no one treated him, so now he's dead. Okay, so we have a stonecutter's table. I'm going to add a bill to make... limestone blocks. I want to make 40 of them. See who will do that. I have a major break risk happening. I don't know who that is. Oh, and a hand tailor bench. So we're going to add bills to make pants. 3 of them. And a bill to make a t-shirt. 3 of them. jackets, three of them. I don't think we're going to get through all of this anytime soon. I don't need parkas because it's not going to get very cold. Cowboy hats, three of them. I just like the way they look when they wear cowboy hats. Nathaniel's about to break. It's his deal. Oh, he's a night owl. So let's restrict him. Let's put him to sleep in these days. And anything this time. There. It'll take a while for his schedule to reset, but I don't know if I did that right. I just kind of wing it when I'm doing that stuff. Uh-oh, what just blew up? Oh, man. So sometimes electrical conduits will fail, and stuff will get set on fire. Come on, put out the fire. Oh, no, we lost one of our solar panels. We lost our other solar panel. Ugh, sigh. Okay. Power, solar panel. Boop, boop. Now our stove is connected to the battery for all the good it does us. We don't have any power. Nathaniel is working diligently to restore our solar power. Oh, and Olga's doing it now too. All right, cool. Come on, build that thing. Build that thing. Hey, build that thing. Good. So now during the day, we'll have power again to fill up our batteries. Oh, she's working hard. She's not. I think I already checked. She's not a night owl. No, she's not. Bloodlust. Gets a rush from hurting people. Twice as likely to start a social fight. Well, that's no bueno. Alright, well, whatever. Okay, batteries are filling up again, cooking some meals, making some clothes. That's good. That's very good. We've got our growing plots running along just fine. Let's look around here. There's another ship chunk. Deconstruct that. Some jade here. Jade is useful for trading because it's worth a fair amount of money. What's in here? Let's deconstruct that and see what's in there. Sometimes it's aliens, and they come out and kill you. So we'll just see what happens. See if anyone will head up there and deconstruct that. Is Nathaniel going to do it? Yeah. Nathaniel's got a major break risk. Area revealed. Okay, cool. This will give us more steel. Steel. Oh, I can't believe I have to single click all of these little walls. Alright. Well, anyway, so that's Rimworld for now. Our colony seems to be moving along just fine. Nothing too catastrophic has happened. I mean, we still have a colony, so that's something. And I think that's going to do it for now. This is a really, really long video, but it's my channel, and I'll make really long videos if I want to. Anyway, if you got all the way through it, even if you didn't, thanks very much for watching, and have a wonderful day.